I did issue a statement actually showing support for the AR statement without any doubt or reservation. I mean, anybody that can do that, what AR is promising, definitely we are going to back them up. But not that we are going to crisscross. If exactly 10 people are coming with the same promise that we are going to run to each 10 of them, we will be very selective whose promises really looks genuine and who's really there for the masses.
Taxi unionist Werner January says that he highly commends the AR activist in chief, Jobo Mupanda, who plans to run for mayor in the Windhoek local authority elections, for committing to liberate taxi drivers from the city police who operate under the leadership of the city of Windhoek.
This is actually, in fact, it's a contract between the taxi drivers and the AR movement, that the moment that they are elected into power in the city of Windhoek, we expect this to happen. And this is but only the first, because it will go beyond the writing off or the cancellation of the warrant of arrest. It must also go into other things, like the taxi ranks that we have been fighting for. I mean, that will also go a long way to alleviate another burden for our drivers.
Today on One spoke to the newly elected AR spokesperson, Simon Amunime, to discuss the objective of this social contract between the taxi union and the AR.
The city police falls under the city of Windhoek leadership, under the stewardship of the mayor. That's why we already want to establish the relationship before we take over in November, to make sure that we are going to cancel those 36,000 warrant of arrest that were issued to our taxi drivers, that we are able to start afresh when we take over the city. So our letter was mainly just a communication in terms of establishing relationship as well as cooperation with the stakeholder that deal on the daily basis with taxi drivers. That we really don't have proper route established. The legislation that are in place is, for example, the Transport Act that is of apartheid of 1977, as well as the violation of those security clusters when it comes to disrupting, arresting, giving tickets to taxi drivers, because we don't also have proper infrastructure in the city where you have to drop off, pick up customers and so forth. One example is, for example, the Namibian University of Science and Technology, NUST, which is previously known as Polytech. You have an institution like that that is very fundamental and very important, but you don't have a taxi rank at such an institution, but you have over 10,000 students that have to get dropped and picked up every day. So you find taxi drivers are getting fined and getting punished for this thing, but it's not their fault. That's why we are saying those are historical mistakes. We want to start off at a new chapter on a new page. That's why we are saying we are calling for the scrapping or cancellation of those 36,000 warrant of arrest. Then as we take over the city, then we look in terms of how are we able to align and make sure that the city have proper infrastructure in terms of accommodating the taxi drivers and making sure that also they are also law-abiding citizens. But we feel that those historical mistakes has to be done away, so we start off at a clear page.
Although the bill was approved by Cabinet this year, January urged the Ministry of Works and Transport to speed up the process by bringing the Public Passenger Road Transport Bill of 2019 to life.